Welcome, dear children. 1 to 5 questions. We had a thorough recap, right? Do you want again to go and just recap of 1 to 5 questions? Do you want me to do that? Yeah. Shall we? So first question is, the music master is making lovely music. Read aloud the sentence in the text that expresses this idea. So what is the sentence given in the book that you have to have a small idea and write that sentence also. The second question, had the beggar come to Rukmani's house for the first time? No. So you have to give reason for that. A sharp V-shaped line had formed between her eyebrows. What did it suggest to you about Rukmani's mood? It was an angry mood. Right? Angry mood. That is the answer, and you just explain what are the reasons for angry. Now complete the following sentence. We saw this, right? Ravi compares Lalit playing the violin to what? Derailing. Right? Trying to hide beneath the tray of chilies, Mahendran tipped a few chilies over himself. The teacher played a few notes on his violin, then Lalit stumbled behind him. Right? The beggar said that the kind ladies of the household kept his body and soul together for a whole week. After the lessons are over, the music teacher asked Lalit if she had seen his chappals. And the second question, describe music master. He will be a bald head, fringe, oiled hair, and the hair is falling around the ears. Old fashioned tuft, a gold chain and the diamond ring glittering when his hands are gliding up and down. So gold bordered vesti and a big toe will be there. So these are all the description of the music teacher. What makes Mridu conclude that the beggar has no money to buy chappals? Because his feet were blizzard, then how can, if he has money, then he could have bought a chappal and this blisters will not be there, isn't it? So what does she suggest to show her concern? She suggested Mridu and Ravi about a pair of old slippers so that they could give it to the beggar. Right? Have you children, she began, and then seeing they were curiously quiet, went on more slowly. Seen anyone lurking around the veranda? Now, what do you think Rukmani really wanted to ask? She wanted to ask the children if they had seen the music master's chappals. Now, why did she change her question? She changed her question because the children were very quiet and she suspected that the children must have done something with the chappals. She knows that. What did she think had happened? She thought that the children had have given the music master's chappal to that old beggar. Yes, she guessed it right, and the same happened. And on getting Gopu Mama's chappal, the music master tried not to look too happy. Why? Because he don't want to show that these chappals are very good than his. He wanted to show that his own chappal was more expensive and the branded one better than Gopu Mama's chappal, right? So is it clear? Now shall we move to the next question? Now really you wanted to write the sixth question now. On getting a gift of chappals, the beggar vanished in a minute. Why was he in such a hurry to leave? On getting a gift of chappals, the beggar vanished in a minute because he did not want to lose the gift of those chappals. His feet were blizzard and he could not have got anything better from that house. Again, children, this is the best gift, okay? And he don't want to lose that gift, right? Already his feet were blizzard and he could not expect a gift more than this from that house. If they come also, there is a chance that he may lose the chappal. So immediately he vanished. On getting a gift of chappals, the beggar vanished in a minute because He did not want to lose the gift of those chapels. His feet were blistered, and he couldn't have got anything better from that house. Right? Is it clear? Shall I move to the next question, dear? Right, seventh question. Walking towards the kitchen with Mridu and Meena, Rukmani began to laugh. What made her laugh? Now, this is a very good question, repeated, often repeated in the question paper. Right, Gopu Mama always in such a hurry to throw off his shoes and socks and get into his chappals as soon as he comes home. Right? So Rukmani began to laugh while thinking about the reaction of her husband after hearing that incident. What incident? When he came to know that they had given this new chapel to the music master, what will be the reaction of his husband? By imagining that, she started laughing. Can you able to understand here? Again, Gopu Mama always in such a hurry to throw off his shoes and socks and get into his chapel as soon as he comes home. Rukmani began to laugh while thinking about the reaction of her husband after hearing this incident, and he came to know about what he wanted to know. They had given his new chapel to the music master. Is it clear? Right. Now, what happens working with language? Working with language. What is working with language? Actually, we are not working, we are not learning, we are experiencing a language. Children, when I say that four cousins, sisters were there, then you are visualizing, you are imagining, you are just seeing in your mind that four children were there. When I show the picture of the children, you just visualize the images that were there in your mind. So we are experiencing a language, right? Now, working with language, you have to read the sentence. It is an if clause. If possible, we'll take the if clause separately. Now, we have to be in a position. You are in a position to complete the book exercise. So if clause, I'm taking it along with the lessons. If she knows we have a cat. The first question is, if she knows we have a cat, Party will leave the house. If she knows, what is that? If she knows, right? Again, 1 minute. The first question, if she knows we have a cat, Party will leave the house. And the second one, she won't be so upset if she knows about the poor beggar with sores on his feet. Children, compare first and second question. You have a comma in between the two sentences. What is the first word in that sentence? If. So, if clause. If clause separated the two sentences using a comma. Can you able to identify that? In the second sentence, there is no comma, right? And where is if? If appears in between the sentence. So children, observe these small details. We will come across these things and we'll discuss about this, right? And the third question, if the chappals do fit, will you really not mind? Where is the comma, dear? The comma is in between the two sentences, and if appeared at the starting of the sentence, right? Notice that each sentence consists of two parts. The first part begins with if, right? So it is known as if clause. Clause, the spelling of clause is C-L-A-U-S-E, not C-L-A-S-S. This clause is different. If clause is different, C-L-A-U-S-E. Is it clear? Now, when you go through more examples, when we are discussing about this, you will understand, I hope. Next slide. Rewrite each of the following pair of sentences, a single sentence. Use if at the beginning of the sentence. Now you will understand, dear, even better than before. First sentence is walk fast. You will catch the bus. So this is a sentence. Walk fast, you have a full stop there. So that is one order, right? Walk fast, you will catch the bus. So if you walk fast, you will catch the bus. If you watch, walk fast, after that come up, you will catch the bus. Don't spit on the road, you will be fined. The second question, don't spit on the road, you will be fined. So don't is a negative word. If clause has to be used only for positive sentence, here you have to change the negative sentence to positive sentence first. Don't spit on the road, right? For that, what I am going to do? Spit on the road. If you spit on the road, it's a positive sentence, right? If you spit on the road, you will be fined. So 3 points we observe. One is separated by a comma. Two parts of sentences are there. It will be separated by a comma. And if has to appear at the starting, so that it is called if clause. And the third point is, it has to be used only for positive sentence. If it is positive sentence, it will be easy for you to write if clause. Shall we move to the next? Yes. So I'll give you 5 more examples. Check it out whether you can able to understand. Don't tire yourself now, you won't be able to work in the evening. So here also don't, it's a negative sentence, make it positive. If you tire yourself now, you won't be able to work in the evening, right? Study regularly, you will do well in the examination. If you study regularly, you will do well in the examination. Work hard, you will pass the examination in the first division. If you work hard, you will pass the examination in the first division. Children, notice that the comma, I mean the full stop, has to be replaced with comma. And the capital letters has to be replaced by small letters. All these are the basic things which you have to understand. Full stop, comma, where it has to come after comma, small letter or capital letter. All these are basic things which you have to understand and write on your own. So fourth one, be polite to people, they will also be polite to you. If you are polite to people, be polite to people, here it has to be changed to, if you are polite to people, they'll also be polite to you. Don't tease the dog, it will bite you. If you tease the dog, it will bite you. So negative sentences, negative words has to be changed to positive. Is it clear, ma'am? Right. So now we'll see the fill in the blanks. Today is Sunday. Right. I am wondering whether I should stay at home or go out. If I go out, I will miss the lovely Sunday lunch at home. Right. One present tense and one future tense. If this is the situation, what is the consequence? What is the result? If I stay for lunch, I will miss the Sunday film showing at Archana Theatre. I think I will go out and see the film only to avoid getting too fat. So first is go and I will miss. If I stay, I will miss. So one is future and one is present tense here. First one, if after, present tense. Then the reaction or the consequences will be in future tense, right? Very good. Now complete the sentences. Don't go to the theater if you don't want. Don't go to the theater if you don't want to. He'll post you later if you want him to. Please use my pen if you want to. He'll lend you his umbrella if you want him to. My neighbor Ramesh will take you to the doctor if you want him to. Don't eat if you don't want to. Children, the time is going to be over, right? Speaking and writing skills, you just go through this, right? Go through this and fill it on your own, right? Any doubts, clarify that. Thank you.